The Indiana General Assembly has passed anti-upskirt legislation. This comes after a News Channel 15 investigation uncovered a loophole in the state's voyeurism law. Tonight, the father of an alleged victim is speaking out on this amendment. As News Channel 15's Adam Widener explains, he is pleased with the legislation, but still looking for closure.
It's a good thing that it finally got passed. It took a while, probably, you know, too long, but it's there.
After a year and a half of waiting and near resolution to an incident surrounding Ed Morrow's daughter, Nelson Butch Miller was accused of snapping upskirt pictures of 10-year-old Abby Morrow and two other women. He was charged with battery because he brushed up against Abby during the alleged incident. That charge was dropped this year.
Not any closure. The case didn't pan out the way we wanted it to, so he got off with just a couple hours in jail and some fines for his original arrest of battery.
The voyeurism statute didn't apply because it only covers areas like restrooms and showers, not a public place like a store.
Hope that he would get just what he deserves. How's that?
News Channel 15 first aired the story in September of 2009. State Senator Tom Weiss tried to pass an updated version of the voyeurism law in 2010, but that was eventually stopped. It didn't cover peeping in all public places, but this new amendment does.
That's why I called News Channel 15, and thanks to Senator Weiss and Aisha and everybody staying on top of it, we got it done.
The amendment makes taking upskirt pictures and videos anywhere a felony. Morrow is glad future generations would be protected from the act, but still feels jaded by what he calls the injustice to his family.
It's hard because knowing people that are still out there doing it and admitting to doing it, and, you know, for those deals where you just got to wait for the process, which takes a while. But finally, hopefully it comes through and justice will prevail.
In Angola, Adam Widener, News Channel 15.
If Governor Daniels signs this amendment into law, it goes into effect July 1st.